Hey folks, here at OS Reviews. You're watching our video review of the Aurin Mini Bluetooth Wireless Headset. This is an inexpensive Bluetooth headset that works great for taking calls, so you can connect with any smartphone on basically any platform. So it works great with BlackBerry OS, iOS, Android, and Windows. What's unique about this particular device is its design that we'll discuss in a moment, and also its price tag, which is only just $15 to $20, which is very inexpensive for a MRSP price. And you can also purchase this device through Amazon.com for just that same listed price, and it arrives within 3 days of shipping, so it's very, very quick. And a good idea for stuffing for a Christmas gift or for a quick holiday season gift if you are looking for that. The packaging is pretty petite and small, and it's recyclable, so it's actually very eco-friendly, and inside we'll find access to the device itself. Again, the device works great with basically any platform. It even works great for tablets as well. Now, what makes this particular device really unique is the fact that it also is capable of playing back music. So instead of just having the capability of taking calls and having a microphone, you can actually use this to listen to tunes and watch videos and movies. And no matter what application you're using, whether it's playing games or, again, watching a video on YouTube, the device will also work as a basic Bluetooth speaker, and you can hear what's happening through the sound in your ear. So it also acts as a mini Bluetooth speaker, which is something that many other Bluetooth headsets don't offer, and they only offer the capability of taking calls and listening to people when they talk. Otherwise, taking a look at the design, it's pretty petite and small, and we have access to the device itself and also a rechargeable cable that you can use to connect the device to charge it with. Unfortunately, the user manual is printed entirely in Mandarin Chinese, rendering it impossible for most users here in the States to actually read it, and that's a bit of a disappointing facet. Taking a look at the device, you have access to this proprietary charger, and it takes about 1.5 hours to fully charge. After charging the device, we found that it lasted us about a week before we had to recharge it, so pretty adequate battery life and performance. Finally, the design of the device is pretty interesting. It has this home button design that's very reminiscent of iOS's home button, so there's a lot of kind of design taken from maybe Apple, the inspiration. It also comes in black and white, so you can choose between two color iterations. There's also a gel tip at the side that you can actually customize and comes within three sizes, large, medium, and small. And the clip here can also be removed as well. So in case you don't want to use the clip, you can just directly insert it into your ears, and it's small enough it's going to stay in place. Again, I find the fact that it's being advertised as a mini Bluetooth speaker to be a bit funny because it's a mono speaker. So even though sound quality is pretty decent for the size of this thing, it is only going to be going through one side of your ear. So if you're watching a movie that has three-dimensional sound, it sounds a bit tinny, a bit strange, just because you only get it from one side of your head. That said, the sound quality of the device is not bad at all. We found that during testing, it provided pretty good performance generally, and in terms of playing back sound, it was pretty rich, had pretty good basses, and a pretty good range in general. And it's not, you know, as great as some of the top-of-the-line Bluetooth headsets out there, but certainly isn't bad for the money. Now, the home key here actually acts as a power on and off key. You long press on it in order to activate the device and turn it on. Afterwards, you receive the Bluetooth indicator, which is a blue LED light that will flash 3 seconds each and three times to tell you that it's currently on and trying to pair with the device. Pairing the device is extremely simple. Simply turn it on, connect to a Bluetooth setting on your device, and it's basically going to get paired. And you don't have to do anything to basically start playing music and taking calls with the device. Taking a closer look at the design, there's a microphone grill on the side of the unit. It's crafted entirely out of a glossy plastic material. There's also the charging port on the side. Now, the plastic material here feels all right, but it is a huge fingerprint magnet, so it's going to attract quite a bit of dust particles, so you do need to clean it sporadically. Also, the LED light is not entirely evenly lit, so if you're distracted by this, it's something to note. But otherwise, it's very easy to connect to, and we found that the range was about 25 meters to 30 meters in connectivity, so pretty good range as well for a Bluetooth device. In general, this device definitely works as advertised. Again, the microphone chipset on here is actually pretty good, and we found that users thought we were talking on our home phone instead of on a cell phone in many instances. So very good connectivity, very good call quality, and the microphone is also pretty impressive. So overall, it definitely does a trick. As far as the Bluetooth headset is considered, it has a nice design going for it, it's simplistic, it's inexpensive, it's slightly on the larger and kind of bizarre side of the design, but if you do want something that also plays back music in addition to being a Bluetooth headset, I think that this is a good option to take a closer look at. You can check out our full in-depth review on this device on our website, but this has been our video review here at OS Reviews. Thanks for watching. This has been the Aurin Mini Bluetooth Headset.